everything Christ suffered was for our benefit. Everything Christ suffered was for our profit. Everything Christ suffered is to our account. He suffered for our offenses. He suffered for our sins. He suffered for our salvation. He suffered for our justification. He suffered for our redemption. He suffered for our deliverance. He suffered for our reconciliation. He suffered for our righteousness. He suffered for our sanctification. He suffered for our freedom. He suffered for our healing. He suffered for our fullness of blessing. He suffered for our acceptance in heaven. Everything you will ever need from here till eternity, everything you'll ever need from the point you come to Christ until you see him face to face, every challenge you will ever face, Christ has solved your problem already. He knew every crossroad you will get to. He knew every pain that will come to you. He knew every plague that will visit you. He knew every problem that will knock at your door. And right there at the whipping post, and right there on the cross, he was thinking of you. He was planning for you. He was suffering for you. And he bore it all for you. And today we come for the revelation. Today we come for the manifestation. And today we come for the participation, because it's going to happen. This moment now, the moment you mention the name of Jesus and you say, he is my Lord, he is my Savior, it's done. Salvation comes immediately. If you want that salvation and you want the Lord God of heaven to write your name in the book of life himself, just raise up your hand and say, Lord, I'm here. It doesn't matter what hole and what depth of degradation you are falling. The moment you say, I mention that name as my Savior, as my Lord, forgiveness will come to you. Keep up that hand. Father, Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for all these who have responded to your invitation and they have come to you as sinners. Take all their sins away in Jesus' name. Give them pardon, forgiveness, freedom, eternal life, and the joy of salvation in Jesus' name. Satan will not reign in your life. Evil spirit will not reign in your life. In your life, the Lord shall reign forever. Over your problems, the Lord shall reign forever. Over that concern that you have, the Lord shall reign forever. That thing will not take your life. It is confirmed in Jesus' name.